Shalom everyone, shalom Mishkan partners with Israel. It's so great to come to you right now, still from the US. You remember, I'm gonna go back to Israel pretty soon and I need you all to join us in our Israel partnership. So just go into the website and find the section where it says support Israel, give to Israel, and just click on that link over there and become a sustainable partner together with us so we can make a great impact in Israel and influence the good lives back home in the country that God chose to be his home. So I'm coming to you now with a quick report about what's happening in Israel right now. It's Friday, and the government of Israel has been functioning over a week right now. They have a lot of challenges, but we can see that things are settling down a little bit. We're getting a lot of issues with the Palestinians. Some of the chief military generals are saying that Israel should be prepared for another round of hostility with the Palestinians, as they don't accept the new government, and they were trying and testing them, thinking they're gonna be really compromising. So what we heard from the Israeli side is they are compromising right now, and they said if they keep the calm just for a few more days, they're gonna reopen the Gaza Strip for more and more goods, and they're gonna extend the fishing zone for the Gazan fishermen, which is very important for their economy. So we think that Israel is, because we have a lot of left-wing supporters in the government and Arabs, they are going much towards the Palestinians and really giving them a slack for literally not accepting the terms that Israel is putting down towards a sustainable ceasefire. So we're going to see what's going to happen. I think that Israel also didn't want to get into a conflict right now while the Israeli chief of staff of the military is still on U.S. soil and negotiating with the Americans about the Iran deal and about how to act against the hostility of Iran and getting to get around the borders of Israel. So this is something that I'm just guessing, probably according to the analyzing of the situation. We heard also that there were all kinds of clandestine activities by the Syrian regime, by Assad, trying to maybe talk more with the Americans to get some kind of a deal over the Golan Heights. So today we heard at least a very comforting news from the American administration that they said that they haven't changed their policy towards the Golan Heights and the fact that Israel has the sovereignty over this part of the land. So at least this is comforting. Another thing that I would like to talk with you about is the fact that in Israel we have been opening the borders for more and more people to come in, doing some experiments about receiving tourists into Israel. Unfortunately, it's not coming about very well right now. We're hearing that there is an escalation of more and more COVID infections with the Indian variant, which is what they call Delta variant, which is very infectious. So we are a little bit worried about that, and we will just pray about that, and hopefully they're going to be able to contain the situation and just do some quarantine in some places and get the things to continue. We were sure that they're going to reopen the borders of Israel for tourists on July 1st, but unfortunately now we're hearing that they're going to postpone it until August 1st, so we just have to pray real hard for things to work out the way they should work out and for tourism to return to Israel. We need those beautiful people that loves Israel, care for Israel, Jews and Gentiles alike, stepping on the soil of the land of Israel, prayer intercessors, and asking God for favor and mercy over this land so we can have more and more people to come over and to witness the goodness of God. Another thing that I would like us to pray for right now is the horrific building collapse near Miami, in Surfside, Miami, a building of 14 stories partially collapsed, and over 99 people are just still unannounced and missing, and we don't know what's happening with them. This building was a building, a condominium shared by Jews and Gentiles that lived together. And we have a lot of Jewish people also missing. We're praying for them. You can go online and look for some of the press releases concerning the names of the people, so you'll even know how to really pray for them by name. And I'm asking the Lord God of Israel for a great miracle, and for many of them to be, all of them if we can, be found alive. And if not, just have mercy over their souls and accept them in your heavens. These are innocent people. They were sleeping in their beds, and at the middle of the night, 2 a.m., they don't know exactly what happened, still trying to investigate, and the building collapsed over the people that were inside. So pray together with us, partner together with us. We need you, we love you, we want to be in unity, Jews, Christians, Gentiles, together in one accord, because if two or three are gathered under the name of God, the Lord God of Israel is in the midst of us, and His presence and our prayers means a lot. So let's get in agreement and have a good Shabbat. Praise God for the Shabbat He has given us, and just enjoy the Shabbat of God and be together. I love you a lot, Dubi. Bye for now.